afternoon. I'm Steve Clark. I'm a partnership executive with Apty, and we have two great speakers today. I thank you for taking the time out of your day to listen to what they have to say. Our two speakers, one is from a partner, Dianex, who is one of our premier partners in Europe. And speaking for Dianex is Bram van der Plas. And we also have a customer, Jan-Peter Moos from IBC Evidencia, who's going to be telling us about his experience working with Dianex and with Apty. So why don't we start with an introduction? Bram, if you could start, introduce yourself, and then Jan-Peter, you can follow Bram.
Sure, Steve. Thanks. Well, first of all, I would like to thank you and Apty for hosting this webinar and giving us the opportunity to talk about this case. Let me briefly introduce myself. I'm Bram van der Plas, Business Development Manager at Dianex, and responsible for building and maintaining our partner network. As a cloud solution provider, we enable our partners with a portfolio that supports them and their customers within their digital transformation journey. One of our solutions is Apty, of which Dianex has the exclusivity to distribute in the EMEA region. And for those who do not know Apty yet, it's a digital adoption platform that accelerates and simplifies the adoption of basically every web-based application. Today we have the honor to speak with Jan-Peter from IV Evidencia, one of our first customers who said yes to Apty and start using Apty. So before we go into detail, I would like to give him the word to introduce himself.
Hi, good morning, good afternoon, depending on where you're at in on the globe. I'm Jan-Peter Moos. I am the one of the applications managers within IVC Evidencia for the Northwestern European region. That's continental Europe. UK is not included in that. I've been working with the company for almost 5 years. I have an IT and aviation background. I've been in automation for the last 20 years. And 5 years ago, when I joined IVC Evidencia, I was asked to design the architecture for upscaling our IT infrastructure. And maybe it's interesting to tell a little bit about IVC Evidencia. We are one of the fastest growing veterinarian companies within the world. We do this mainly by acquisition. So we acquire veterinarian clinics. They join our group and we have to integrate them within our company and within our systems and our processes. As you can imagine, that is quite a challenge over the last 5 years. Over the last 5 years, we've had a yearly growth of over 100%. So we have to onboard 40 to 50 different clinics annually. And that's one of our main challenges. IVC Evidencia as a whole, we are a global veterinarian group based out of the UK. We are situated in mainly continental Europe, and we have we started to use Apty within the Netherlands as a trial. We've been working with Apty for the last year. I think that will be enough for the introduction.
Great. Thank you, Jan-Peter. So now, if you could advance, please. So Jan-Peter, as you know, no one goes out and just buys software for the sake of buying software. So what were some of the challenges you were facing that led you to explore options like Apty prior to reaching out to Dianex?
Yeah, clear. Like I mentioned, our growth is mainly due to acquisition. So we had to onboard 40 to 50 clinics annually. On average, a clinic has somewhere between, let's say, 5 to 100 employees with all their incumbent systems and processes, or sometimes there is no software at all. We have acquired clinics that still work with pencil and paper. So you can imagine there's a huge challenge in getting them to work with our systems and processes, getting them familiar with new platforms. And for us as a group, it was very important to get hands on where the money goes. And in a company like a veterinary clinic, most of the money goes to people. Those are the most important resources that we have, but also the most costly. So time registration is very important. Rostering is very important. So one of the first things that we did 4 or 5 years ago is implement an HR system and a time registration system. And the funny thing is that we didn't really know we had a problem. We were contacted by Dianex because they wanted to pitch Apty by one of our former partners who changed his job to Dianex. And he knew our company very well. And he also knew exactly what problems we were running into, even though we didn't realize we had those problems. But if you want to onboard a lot of people with different IT backgrounds or no IT background at all into one particular system, you run into a lot of challenges. And because we use the system on a daily basis, you don't see the challenges and the problems anymore. But the new employees who had to onboard found it difficult to get to use to the new systems, to start using it. They were accustomed to their old system. Dianex basically showed us that we could improve on our onboarding process by helping our employees onboard within our platform to get used to our systems by using the Apty workflows as a tool to help them with their onboarding.
Peter, were there any specific business processes that you were having trouble with, especially when it comes to like cross-platform, going from one system to the other, that you were experiencing, and how did you find that Apty helped you with that?
Yeah, good question. Because we have separate systems for our timekeeping and rostering on one hand and our HR platform on the other hand, for instance, with our leave balance, the leave balance is registered within our HR platform. But if you want to take leave, you have to register in the planning software. And those are two different platforms. So if you want to take time off, you have to know what your balance is and you have to switch between the two different systems. We didn't think that was a problem, and maybe it isn't a real problem, but people who are not accustomed to working on computers at all, they find it a hassle that they have to log on to two separate systems to do one single job. They have to do it within usually their daily job where they are not behind a computer, so they have to take special time out of their roster to sit down and start up the computer. So it was not really a problem, but it was a hassle. And with Apty, we created a balance button in our request leave form in our time registering and planning software, where when they request time off, they can just press the button and it directs them directly to our HR platform and it shows them their own leave balance, so that within one press of a button, they can check how much leave they have forward or coming to them, and they can register their request, which was a real improvement in efficiency, not really in time, but very much more in employee happiness, if that's a thing.
Yes.
It took away the hassle of requesting leave, which sounds like an insignificant thing, but really improved on the employee happiness and well-being. And you see that back in how they feel about your company. So there was a major improvement, which was a very small thing to do.
Thanks. Can we advance the slide, please? Thank you. So Jan-Peter, what would you say was your discovery process in finding Apty as your solution?
I think that initially we were contacted by Dynamics with this new feature they had called Apty, and we want to be the most innovative player within our branch. We decided just give it a try. Didn't really see at first the advantages that it could bring. But once we tried it out, it was so easy to use, and it really brought forward the problems and challenges that we have, well, not we, but our employees have in the daily use of our systems, that it became a valuable tool within just weeks' time. So the discovery was not beforehand, but afterwards, after trying it out, it really proved its value. So initially, we didn't realize we had a problem. Everybody was happy with the way it worked. Then we implemented Apty, and we, within weeks, we saw improvement in the use of our systems, in the way that people felt about the systems that we were rolling out within the new clinics. So I think that it was more of a realization afterwards that we had a great tool in hands, and not really the discovery beforehand, which was a nice surprise. So yeah, that was the main thing, I think.
Thank you. Brahm, so from a Dynamics perspective, what business processes did Dynamics want to focus on from an engagement perspective? And, you know, how did the Apty platform help you to position a solution for IVC Evidencia?
Yeah, good question. Jan-Peter already explained that they did a vast amount of takeovers, acquisitions. So many new employees needed to be onboarded in those two new applications. They use AFAS and Deflexis at their company. So you can imagine that someone who worked for a long period with a specific application, and then there is a change and they need to, out of a suddenly use a new application, that can, be quite hard for some people to change, to adapt to it. So what we did with Apty was we created workflows, tooltips, validations to guide them through the new processes. Of course, you need to do the adoption the best way as possible, and that's where Apty came in. And I think a great example of what we did was what Jan-Peter already mentioned. Was this check balance button. So it saved a lot of time and frustration to open a new application, or maybe they don't know where to find this balance. And an extra for IVC Evidencia was that the IT support tickets reduced dramatically because of Apty. So yeah, that was, I think, the main win for us at IVC Evidencia.
Great. So here's a question for both of you. We'll start with Jan-Peter. As customers and other partners are on this webinar, they're listening to the solution. They're perhaps thinking this might be a fit for them. What would you say your implementation experience was from a resource and a time investment to implement Apty?
Yeah, that's a very important question. If I look at our implementation, I was amazed at the ease of use of Apty. And let me give you an example. I got my login credentials on a Wednesday, and I had a meeting set on the following Friday for my first initial training to get a look and feel and show around of how the system actually works and how I could build and implement my own workflows and things like that. And as a techie, you tend to look around within the software before you actually go to the first training. By the time I had my training on the Friday morning, I had already built successfully and implemented my first two workflows. So that really showed me how easy it was to design the workflows and set up everything within Apty. There's hardly any training that you need, providing that you already have a little IT skills. The biggest challenge that we have is knowing what our processes are. And that might sound funny, but the processes are clear on a daily basis because everybody does what he or she is supposed to do. But if you have to write out the process in a changing company, documentation is very poor. The processes were virtually unknown, even though they worked. So finding out what the right process is, finding out the best way of work, and designing a workflow, that's the hardest part. Once you know what you want to achieve, setting it up in Apty was a piece of cake.
Great. So just a quick follow-up question is, when did you, I know that this the Apty solution was brought to you from Dianex, but what did you know about digital adoption platforms prior to that?
Nothing. Honestly, nothing. We never thought about it.
Okay. If we could advance the slide, please. So of course, you know, with any solution, does it deliver the value you expected? And one of the things we say with Apty is sometimes just to get the value or the ROI out of the software you already own, a digital adoption platform is essential. And here on this slide, we're looking at some numbers, and there are some interesting numbers here. You know, 100% decrease in IT support, the intuitive workflows in five different languages, you know, and you have a number of people using Apty. So let me ask you, Jan-Peter, what value are you seeing in this from this from a business perspective?
Well, we haven't monetized the value, but that's, I think, the only thing we haven't done. What we see is that in our workload, in our support department, shared service center, we have seen a huge reduction in IT tickets, because now people actually follow the right workflow. They press the right buttons and they know what input is needed to get the system to work. So it has really improved the way that our employees use our systems, which is a reduction in IT tickets, but also really improved the way that people think about IT. Usually, in most companies, people don't think very, very nice about IT because IT is considered a hassle, a problem. It's something you have to do. It has to do with administrating your time, your system, while you're actually doing a different job. But this really has reduced the time and effort that our employees take within the systems. So it has improved the basically the culture within our company as well. Also, for employee branding, because we acquire various different clinics with different cultures, different brandings, getting them to be one of the IVC Evidentia family, this really has contributed strongly because the help function that we have created using Apty is the same in every single system that we use. So even though that the look and feel of our HR platform is different and varies broadly from our time registering system or even our bookkeeping system or our practice management system, the help button is always situated on exactly the same location in your screen. Would you say the identity, the way it looks and feels, is the same? The way it works is the same. So every different platform, no matter what platform it is, it becomes familiar because they know how to navigate through the system using Apty. So that really has improved a lot. And what is really cool, because we have a shortage of veterinarians within Europe, we also have a lot of vets from abroad. So we have Polish vets, Spanish vets, Greek vets, and they don't speak Dutch. But I can translate the workflows within Apty very, very easy. So I set up the workflow once, and then I just put in the different languages. So no matter what your native tongue is, Apty will help you through our systems, which is a really, really improvement in how people think and feel about IVC Evidentia, the time it takes them to do their work. So from a business point of view, we haven't monetized the improvement, but we can feel it within our company culture.
Great. So in a sense, you've almost decoupled IT from the user experience, because it becomes more integrated when you include Apty in the application interface. So how would you say it's affecting also, two questions. How has change management been since you've put Apty in, when you're changing the system or making changes to it? And then also, from an acquisition perspective, from a business perspective on acquisitions, have your acquisitions taken less time, and have they become more easy to do?
Let me start with the acquisitions first. The acquisition itself is not... in the acquisition itself, we don't use Apty, obviously, but in the integrating afterwards, that really, really helps, because it's so intuitive to use that it helps people just getting to use to our systems. And in the change management, that goes sort of the same. It doesn't matter that the platform that they use changes, because the way that Apty works and looks and feels doesn't really change. And we just update the workflow in the background if we have a major change in one of our systems, and Apty will just take you by the hand. I mean, that's really what it does. You just tell Apty to start up a certain workflow, for instance, your time registering workflow, and we can change the system entirely. I'm even confident that we could introduce a completely different timekeeping tool, entirely different. But if we set up the workflow right in Apty, people will know how to register time from day one, because they just follow the Apty workflow, which is always has the same look and feel, no matter how we change it.
Yeah, so basically,
does that answer your question?
Yes, it does. Thank you very much. Brom, did you have something to add?
Yeah, in my opinion, what is a really strong point of Apty is that basically all new employees can just open their laptops and start using a completely new application without having any user training or manuals with them. And yep. So that's especially for a company who does a lot of takeovers, and all those new employees needs to be onboarded in those new applications. It comes in quite handy, of course. And that's the strength of Apty. And you can also push, let's say, announcements of new versions or new features, for instance, where you can just give them a little bit more information about something which has changed. And I think change is for a lot of people in this world, of course, it's not always that easy. So when you can, what Peter also mentioned, get them by the hand and just guide them through the system, yeah, that helps, of course, a lot with the user experience of new applications. Yeah,
great. So yeah,
just to give Steve, let's just give me time for a small example.
Please.
What we do monthly is our payroll, and that means that once a month we have to acquire all the time registration, time of work, everything, and bunch it up together for our payroll department. But a manager doesn't do this as a daily job. This is an occurrence once a month. So 12 times a year, you have to go through the payroll process as a manager. You're not a payroll employee. You're just a locations manager, but you have to do the timekeeping of your employees. And because it's not a system that you use daily, because it's a 12 times a year occurring event, but it's very important. I mean, if you screw up the payroll, You have very unhappy employees, and that's the one thing you don't want in a company. So by using Apty, they are confident that they have the right workflow, that they do the process right. They are confident that at the end of the month, everything is in check, everything is in balance. So it also helps them in doing the job in a better way, without them actually getting used to using the system. Most of us, we use the same platforms, same systems on a daily basis. You don't have to explain how Outlook works, because you open it up early in the morning, you close it down at the end of the day, and it's familiar to you. But a system that you only use once a month is a new challenge every coming month, over and over and over again. And it, especially when it's a system that's this important, that puts a lot of pressure on your people. But by Apty, they are familiar, they are confident, and it really helps them to work with it. And that shows how easy Apty is to work with. But it proves more that it will give the confidence and the right way of work for your people. Everybody does everything in the same way, the same time.
Yeah, very good. So one last question, and then we can we can wrap up. And the question is, digital adoption is sometimes hard to quantify because there's not a really good way of measuring it. So how were you measuring digital adoption prior to Apty, and how are you measuring it now? And when I say measuring digital adoption, the use of the system, how successful people are in using that those processes, as you mentioned. So do you have anything to add to how you measured prior and since?
Well, we are an Azure or Microsoft-based company. And within Azure, there are a lot of tools to see how many times people log on and how long they are within the system. You can't really see what they do exactly, and it goes for most of the system. So you have quite an extensive idea of how many percent of your employees actually use the system and how often, but that's where it stops. And the nice thing about Apty, if you have set up the workflows right, it will not only show you how many times it is used, but it also shows you what's the average time that it takes on a workflow. If people don't complete the workflow, where do they break it off? And if a break off happens often at the same step within the workflow, the process, it might give you an insight that maybe your workflow is not complete, is not correct. So it gives us also the opportunity to improve the platforms that we actually use. Apty gives us a lot more insight in the way that our platforms are used, where previous we could only tell that they were used, but not how. So I think that's an improvement. We never asked ourselves if we needed to know the information. Now that we do, I don't think we can turn back.
Wonderful. Well, Jan Peter and Bram, thank you so much for taking time to answer some of the questions we have. If we could go to the next slide, please. I hope everyone who's been participating sees that, you know, Apty is a tool that can help you to, you know, smooth out your onboarding, to reduce your the support tickets, optimize your training, give you data to see where users are engaging and where they're not, and also just helping them to use the system more easily. So we would love to talk with you more, starting with a conversation with Dianex. So Bram, if you could just tell us, you know, how you would like to talk with anyone who has questions after this and how they should reach out to you, and you can tell them a little bit about the process with Dianex.
Yeah, sure, Steve. Well, yeah, if you're facing adoption challenges yourself, or maybe you're about to implement new software Just feel free to contact me. You can send me an email, or you can call me. I will be happy to connect you with one of our partners. They can discuss further possibilities with you. But also, we are looking to expand our partner network. So if Apty fits well in your own services, or maybe this is one as a solution for your customers, then feel free to contact me, and I will happily be talking to you about the possibilities around a partnership with us. So that's basically it.
Great. Well, thank you so much. We're going to do a Q&A session now. So if you have questions, there is a Q&A button at the bottom of the screen within Zoom. If you want to just click on that, you can ask a question, and we will post it to our panelists. We have one question now. And it's, how do you organize the onboarding of a new user? Is it a mix of coaching and e-learning, or what is the process now that you have Apty?
Jumpy, they're also good, of course.
Okay. Yeah. It depends on how you look at the question. For the IT part of Apty, we have a training within our IT department to get our IT our engineers familiar with the Apty Studio and building the workflows, and that's a co-creation with the department concerned with the processes. So if it's a HR system, it's a co-creation with our HR department. If it's a financial process, with our finance department, etc. For the user end, there is no onboarding. They just have a help me button on their screen, and it's just a click and go. It shows us. It just tells you what to do. So it says help question, and you press the button. And you can just type in a question, and it will take you to wherever you need to go. It's even more simple than Google.
Gotcha. We have another question. Or Brom, did you?
Can I add something, Steve, to this?
Please.
Yes, because we as Dianics, we are always there for second line support, of course, and we are also responsible for getting our partners up to speed to basically train the end customer in creating content. So one thing we can help you with getting up to speed with the use of Apty, our partners can do that. And what Jan-Peter also mentioned already is that it's like basically, when you start using Apty, you will see within a few days how it works. So that's, I think, a strong point of Apty. But there are lots of options to get to know Apty. So that was my,
Great. One of the questions we have is, what will you do next with the Apty software platform? Are there other features that you want to use that you're not currently using? And where do you think you're going to take this? I know you started with a smaller subset of clinics. What's your plans moving forward, Jan-Peter?
My plans, and they might vary from our company, because I have different priorities for our department than the company as a whole, but I would like to roll out Apty throughout all of our platforms, instead of just the main platforms that we are currently using. And we have set it up for the Netherlands for now, and seeing how much it helps in supporting our company's growth, I would like to roll it out throughout at least mainland Europe, or start with the Benelux first, because it really reduces a lot of workload within our IT department, and they are busy onboarding, hooking up new locations on a daily basis. So if I can reduce some of their workflow by implementing Apty, that would be really nice. So that will be something to look forward in end of this year, 2024, maybe. Yeah.
Great. Jan-Peter, From a business perspective, one of the questions is who is involved in the strategy or the process? Did you use a center of excellence, stakeholders, it's the partners, department leads to make this successful? And again, it asks, how long did it take to implement with those involved?
Yeah, that's a very good question. You have to understand that 4 years ago, we were a startup. We had, when I joined the company, we had about 40 employees. We have grown just in the Netherlands to over close to 4,000 employees. Globally, we have grown to more than 20,000 employees. So when we started with Apty about a little over a year and a half ago, we were not set up for something like this. It was just me, myself, and I, basically. Now we have, just for the Netherlands alone, we have an IT department of 35 employees, and we would have to go through the change management board, and it would be a lot more different. But this already is an incumbent system. We have it, we use it, and we're just rolling it out. So I think from that aspect, it was fairly easy to get Apty on board. If we would have been introduced to Apty now, present day, it wouldn't have gone so easy. We would have had to build a business case and really show that it would prove or improve something, and it would have been a lot more of a challenge. It was more of a cowboy culture a year and a half ago. Yeah, it was way easier then. Yeah.
Gotcha. One question is also, looking back retrospectively, is there anything that you would have done differently?
Definitely. The two main challenges that I have using Apty, one is getting the right information from our company, from our departments, to actually set up a good working workflow that includes and checks all the tick boxes. Like I said, we have grown so tremendously fast over the last 4 or 5 years, and things have been changing basically on a daily basis. We have very poor or close to none documentation. So finding out what is the best way of work, what are our real processes, was a big challenge. And I kind of did that with my colleagues on the fly. And that means that we had to backtrack way too many times. It was very inefficient. So if I, for the next rolling out that we're going to do, we are first going to have the department that it concerns design the process. What do you need? What is it going to look like? What information do you want to have displayed on the Apty tool, things like that. So that was one thing. And the other thing that that I really ran into is that people who don't have problems using our systems on a daily basis don't see the advantages of a tool like Apty. And those people are usually in the board. They don't work on, they're not operational. They don't work on the workflow. They know the systems that we have, but they are basically unfamiliar with them because they use different systems. So they don't see the challenges. Getting approval of expanding Apty within our company can be challenging from time to time. And what I would change is I would get a buy-in from C-level and get them really into the process to help me within the company rolling out Apty. Those are two things that I would definitely do different. Yeah.
Okay, well, thank you. That kind of rolls into, I think, our last question, which is, now that you have business metrics as far as, you know, how the new business success has been, and, you know, the Apty providing you data with software adoption, you know, are you using those as benchmarks or goals for future workflows or acquisitions? And where do you think you would use that data, especially for those who are listening to your story. You know, now that you have the more insightful, the more meaningful data, how are you using that? And how would you use that to successfully measure an acquisition or an adoption?
Yeah, well, currently we are very much still in the process of improving our platforms and processes. And the metrics that come out of Apty are really helpful in improving the steps within our processes. And for looking to the future, I think that for at least another 6 months to a year, maybe, that will be the main use of the metrics, because we are flying as a company, but more like a lame duck. So there, we need a lot of improvements. So that's our focus for now. But it will also, in the future, we might change our onboarding process, based on the metrics. So that will be something, but I really haven't thought about it that much yet. We are very much in the process of improving still. We are not there yet. And that's what the metrics help. That's where the metrics help. Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. So one last question just snuck in, and it was, how easy is it to manage Apty yourself via the applications or managers or the process owners? How are you managing the Apty system on top of the systems that you're already managing? And how easy is that?
I think that would be fairly easy. We have currently three people who manage Apty. Two of them are junior engineers. They lack the CSS and Java skills of a senior engineer, but those are not really necessary for maintaining the system. And then we have one senior engineer with sufficient knowledge to build new workflows or aid our colleagues. We have set up we have a few hours of consultancy with Dianex, who will help us if we run into problems. We agreed on, I don't know, I was 10 or 15 or maybe 20 hours back in October of 2020, and we still haven't used up our time. So it really shows that it's a very, very self-sufficient program. You don't need that much help. So maintaining Apty is not really a challenge. You need a little IT skills, but that's it. I think almost anybody can use it.
Great, thank you. And then I know we covered this earlier in the webinar, but the question just popped up. How long did it take to implement Apty in your environment?
To implement it, to fully implement it with all the workflows up and running, it took me about 12 weeks. That was start to finish, but without any training. And I cannot stress how fun it was, but without any training, I got two workflows up and running within 3 hours, all by myself. It's that intuitive and that easy to use. So depending on how well you have already thought out your processes, because that was one of my biggest challenges, how well you have already designed and thought out your processes, it will take you less or more time. But the actual building of a workflow is a piece of cake.
Great, thank you. Well, we are coming to the end of the time we had scheduled. I want to just personally say thank you to you, Jan-Peter, and to you, Bram, for your time and kind of taking our listeners through this process and answering their questions. So I really appreciate that. And I think it was a valuable session. Sonam, do you want to wrap this up, or how do you want to take it from here?
First of all, fantastic topic. And thank you everyone, Bram, Jan-Peter, to join us today for this webinar. And I'm really excited. People asked great questions. And we do have some questions about how they can see it in action, the application. So I've posted the link in the chat. Also, guys, we'll be sending the case study of IVC Evidencia and one other healthcare client that we have post the webinar. But just in case you guys have any questions, please contact Ionix and your partners to learn more about Apty and how we can improve your digital adoption. So thank you again, everyone, and see you all next time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, of course. I'm also more than happy to give you a personalized demo, of course. You can contact me via LinkedIn, for instance, to just request this demo. And of course, no problem at all.
Wonderful. Thanks, everyone. I really appreciate it.
Thank you. Bye-bye.